Need for Speed Heat is a high-octane action-packed game supplemented by thrilling graphics with its frustrations, a huge amount of challenge and incredible customization. It's shaping up to be quite a comeback for a franchise that has been spinning its wheels desperately looking for traction. The developer Ghost has finally built something that feels true to its past. Heat is fast, thrilling, gripping, and way, way ahead of its disappointing predecessor, Need for Speed Payback, that debuted in 2017. Before we get to it, this video has been sponsored by Vivid Gold. Hit Vivid Gold up at www.vividgold.co.ke for all your gaming needs, from the latest and greatest games to gaming consoles. Link in the description. Hit that subscribe button if you haven't, hold on to your pants, and let's get straight to it.
Anna, I'm on the bridge! That cop's trying to...
Now, immediately I got Need for Speed Heat and grabbed my controller, I noticed a few tweaks in the driving and handling experience. By default, a drift can be initiated by getting off the gas for a sec and smashing back on it immediately when turning into a corner. And that might be problematic for a bulk of people who like it old school by just using the brake to initiate the drift and the handbrake to angle the car into a drift. Luckily, with live tuning, you can easily switch from using gas to drift to using the brake all within the game, not from the pause menu or the garage menu. Speaking of live tuning, it gives you the option to tweak traction control, steering sensitivity, and downforce accordingly, all from within the game. Drifts are shorter in Need for Speed Heat, but you have more control over the angle of the drift, making it more enjoyable. However, keep in mind that the car you drive also has a say in the drift. Example, drifting in the BMW M3 gives you wilder drifts than drifting in, say, the Lotus Exige or a Porsche 911. Ghost has dropped some welcome tweaks into Need for Speed Heat. If you look closely, you'll see the intense cop chases from Need for Speed Most Wanted and classic Need for Speed Underground theme. Palm City is the new playground for Need for Speed Heat, being the major highlight of the game. The city itself nudges you more to the exploration aspect of the game far better than Need for Speed Payback. Heat's main hooking point is that there are two distinct modes from which to switch from to access various events, and switching between them is done manually before you leave the garage. Data in Palm City includes sanctioned street races on marked locations that earn you bank with each win. It's decent but might pass as plain when you actually stop to recognize detail. Nighttime races, on the other hand, are all about fast racing to build drop points and escape from the cops. In my opinion, Heat looks more amazing at night, especially with the rain and aggressive cop chases and having to dodge traffic that increases significantly at night over daytime. I also like that Need for Speed Heat gives you the power to switch from daytime to nighttime at any time. Both daytime and nighttime events are needed to progress through the story, and the cutscenes and events really set it apart from the cringy story back in Need for Speed Payback.
What did you do? What'd you do to that sweet-ass ride?
You lost the car.
He lost the car.
No, Shaw. This is on you.
You're gonna wish you never survived.
Who says he did?
What are we doing here?
Sending a message.
Wait, stop!
Hey, he said...
We're on camera back there!
Shaw, hold it.
Cop chases are not restricted to predefined time droughts like in Payback, but the cop cars here can really haul ass, and chases are much more tougher to evade. There's also a damage meter for your car this time, so while you can fight back and get car repairs from shops for up to 3 times a night, if you pull too much rough action, you will get wrecked, arrested, and lose rep points. You also have the option to bribe cops this time round, but that only happens when your heat is low and before chase heats up. However, the police AI does cheat at times by popping out cops in front of you in close proximity when you're in the thick of it, and that buster timer can really be unfair to you at times. I honestly don't see the need for a timer if your car can only take damage for a set number of times. I get it, it's all in favor of thrashing some more adrenaline into your system, especially with the risk of losing huge bank and rep points, but getting busted when there's nobody in front or behind me just because the timer ran out is just baloney, especially when I have to lose all that bank and rep. I haven't thrown my controller at the TV yet, but there have been some close calls. There's a good selection of cars available to choose from, but there's lack of luster in the garage, especially if you're a veteran of Need for Speed Payback. This is because bulk of the collection of cars here spans from that game. It's good to see that Ferrari have climbed back on board in Need for Speed Heat, as seen from the abundance of Ferraris in the game. Sadly though, Toyota is still absent. I was actually really hoping I'd see the new Toyota Supra included in the game. There's also a wide array of beast machines from the 90s. Need for Speed Heat also does away with requirements for specific cars to race an event like what you saw back in Need for Speed Payback. Any car I've bought so far can be tuned and retuned in the garage to suit the race at hand, be it drifting, circuits or off-road races, even buying duplicate parts. Speaking of the garage, this upgrade system is a massive leap from the Payback garage. Beyond a few reward items, there are no more hoops to jump through to apply cosmetics or convoluted pump-ups to tune your performance. If you want a part, just buy it. That's how it should be. One confusing addition though is the presence of drag tires in the garage without a dedicated drag mode. What's up, Ghost? Another big new addition is the engine swap that allows you to increase the performance potential of cars that would have previously been underpowered out in a race. All in all, the best new option in my books is exhaust tuning, which allows you to tweak the already sweet exhaust notes. If anyone out there sees car games are work these days in terms of upgrades, just show them this video, because that is one badass geeky upgrade for us petrol heads out there, and I am all about it. Vinyl changing remains top notch, and stance is also retained for you guys that want your cars to have rickety stances. There's also avatar customization too, if you've always wanted to change the clothes of your gaming character. To add on that, there's a wide range of characters to choose from, and all of them look like fugitives from the law. While Need for Speed Heat feels like it's in desperate need of a revolution, as all games do these days, in trend-setting strides, developer Ghost has definitely pinched nostalgic sweet parts off other installments in the almost 25-year-old franchise, put it in a bucket with technology and sweet graphics, and pulled out something wildly respectable and worth our time. Need for Speed Heat isn't all sizzle and dazzle, but it's way, way above what I expected, and definitely one of the best racing games in the long lineup of what we've had all these years. If you want to pick up Need for Speed Heat and other racing games, or all types of games and consoles, remember to hit Vivid Gold up with the link in the description below. If you want more racing and everything else gaming, make sure you hit that subscribe button and turn on the notification bell so you don't miss any game and tech reviews coming to the channel. Leave a like to this video, drop me a comment down below, share this video with your petrolhead friends, and let me see you in the next one. Peace.